Good evening, everybody. Welcome to PNC Park in Pittsburgh. Welcome to Phillies baseball. And tonight, the Phillies will take on the Pittsburgh Pirates. Welcome to Phillies Baseball and Video Game Network. Brandon G here with you. The Phillies and the Pirates are coming off of a win against the Reds, which they won in extra innings, 6-5. Trying to take another series against the Pirates here at PNC Park. This place opened in 2001. When they played at Three Rivers Stadium. Starting lineup for the Philadelphia Phillies. You got Rivera, Utley, Jordan, Franco, Beltre, Perez, Ruff, Dominic Brown, and pitcher Cliff Lee. And they'll go up against Jeff Locke, who is 2-5 with a 6.83 ERA. His 10th game, 54 innings, gave up 71 hits, 29 walks, and 48 strikeouts. Ben Rivera will lead off for the Phillies. He's batting at 256. And the first pitch is inside for a ball, one ball and no strikes.
First pitch, 707.
One strike. 62 degrees at game time.
Ball, that's in.
Two balls and one strike. They said the Phillies beat the Reds a couple days ago, 6-5. Ben Rivera had a home run in that one.
Three balls, one strike.
And now he faces ahead of the count, three balls and one strike. Chase Utley waits on deck.
Get up,
now the count is full. Call looking on strikes. Rivera didn't agree with that call. He was ahead 3-1. He's caught looking. One down him in the first. You see the scouting report for Jeff Locke. That four-seam fastball is one of his best pitches. Here is Chase Utley. He's batting at 298 with 9 home runs and 28 RBIs. Up high and inside, one ball and no strikes.
Right, ooh.
1-1. Utley in a left field, that's a base hit. So Utley is a lead, one out base runner here in the first. And they'll bring up Brandon Jordan, who's batting third today. 7 home runs, Phillies tweaked their lineup and they put Jordan at third. He was the fourth hitter, but they gave that position to Salvador Perez. Ball bounces low, one ball and no strikes. Jordan sends this one in a deep center field. That ball's hit a ton and makes the catch. McCutcheon right in front of the fence. He was up against the fence. He hit that one a ton. Two outs here. In the first inning, here's Mikel Franco. He's batting fourth today, batting at 305. I said Salvador Perez, it was Mikel Franco who was batting fourth. One strike to Franco. And he beats it foul, two strikes. Another foul, 0-2. On floor, one ball and two strikes. That pitch was... He thought he had strike three there. Lock will work again. Now the count is full. Bring up Adrian Beltre. Beltre batting at 272. Since he's hit that 500th home run, he's really cooled off a little bit. And Beltre skies this one to left, but didn't get a whole lot under it. That'll end in the top of the first. The Phillies leave two on. We go to the bottom of the first. Phillies nothing. Pirates coming to bat. You're watching Phillies baseball on the Video Game Network. The lineup for the Pirates: Marte, Tabata, McCutchen, Harrison, Mercer, Walker, Hart, Cervelli, and Jeff Locke. They will face Cole Hamels. 4-4, 3.55 ERA, 17 walks and 23 strikeouts. This is his 13th game. And Sterling Marte will lead it off for the Pirates, batting at 280. Marte hits it. Foul, one strike. One ball and one strike. One and two. Center field, Marte is on with a leadoff single.
Batting second, right fielder.
And he'll bring up Jose Tabata. Tabata batting at 274. One strike. Pitch out. No threat of running here. beats a foul. And a center field, Ben Revere. One out. Andrew McCutchen batting at 284. He's got 11 home runs and 30 RBIs. McCutchen hits this one in the right center field. Revere going back and he makes the catch. Running toward the fence, so it's two outs here in the bottom of the first. What a running catch by Ben Revere. Revere had to run hard for this one. But he does a nice job of running it down. There's Jose Harrison batting at 314. He's got 11 home runs. .314 batting average. One ball and no strikes. One and one. Ball and two strikes. With Lee doing a nice job after giving up the leadoff hit. And hit him. Harrison's hit by the pitch. Is Jordy Mercer. One ball and no strikes. Ball center field, Ben Revere, and he will put it away, and that will end the bottom of the first. The Pirates lead 2. We go to the second. No score. Here is Salvador Perez batting at 234. He's got 7 home runs. He's 2-for-20 in his last 5. Ohio River. Now on his foul. One out. Sterling Marte making the play. And they'll bring up Darren Ruff batting at 336. 6 home runs, 19 RBIs. One ball and no strikes. The announcer chosen for this broadcast was chosen by Sony Entertainment. And the Philadelphia Phillies. Approved by the Philadelphia Phillies. As rough fouls. Two balls and one strike. Nice pitch, 2-2. And Ruff has been on a tear. He's not gone under 300. He's been hitting the ball well. Full count, Dominic Brown waits on deck. He walked. Dominic Brown.
Batting eight, the left fielder, number nine, Dominic Brown.
Brown batting at 229.
Still.
Brown pops it up. Ruff ran on the pitch, but Jose Harrison puts it away, and that is two outs. Here's Cliff Lee. Ball and no strikes.
One ball, one strike.
Ball and one strike. Base hit, center field. Cliff Lee is on with a single. Yeah, Darren Ruff moves up to second base. Nice hit by Cliff Lee. And they'll bring up Ben Revere. One ball and no strikes. Lock has thrown 35 pitches. Gets it off the end of the bat, but he flies it out to Sterling Marte, and that will end the top of the second. Phillies get a hit in the inning. They lead two. We go to the bottom of the second. No score. It's Neil Walker batting at 238 with 9 home runs. Pirates lead the league in home runs. Ball and no strikes. But the record wouldn't say otherwise. Two and nothing. Two balls and one strike. That is a fair ball down the third base side. And Neil Walker leads it off with a base hit.
Batting seven, first baseman, Corey Hart.
And they'll bring up Corey Hart batting at 222. Walker extends his hitting streak to 9 games with that base hit. Inside for a ball, 1 ball and no strikes. Another hit. Jordan stumbled a little bit but got the ball back in play. Goes in the third. Pirates have their first 2 men on base here in the second inning. They'll bring up Francisco Cervelli, the catcher, batting at 208. One ball and no strikes. Fly ball, center field. There makes the catch. They'll bring up Jeff Locke. Jeff Locke, the pitcher. And he squares the bunt, he bunts it foul. Takes it up high, 1 ball and 1 strike. Pirates looking to sacrifice an out and to move runners to second and third. Good bunt. Goes the first for the out. Runners move up to second and third. Walker to third, Hart to second. They'll bring up Sterling Marte. Marte single in his first time up. Fly ball, right field, hit pretty well. Jordan going back is going to bounce off the wall. The Pirates will have a 2-0 lead. Marte on his way to third. He's got a stand-up triple. Nice hit by Sterling Marte. Knocks in 2 runs with a 2-run triple. Pirates lead it 2-0. Here's Jose Tabata. He flew out his last time up. One strike. You will hear a radio simulcast with me in the fourth inning, Matt Paskersian, and crew will take over in the fifth and sixth. And I'll be back in the seventh. Here's the program reminder. 1 ball and 1 strike. Hey. 1-2. Another foul, 1 ball and 2 strikes. It's 2-2. Okay. Full count now. Andrew McCutchen waiting on deck. You want to save him to the third. And you don't want him coming up with runners on first and third. On to Utley. Fires over the rough for the out. Pirates did score two runs in the inning on a two-run triple by Sterling Marte. We go to the third, 2-0 Pittsburgh. Here's Chase Utley.
Second baseman, Chase Utley.
He had to hit his first time up and takes a strike. Utley again, a base hit to right field. Well, Utley's second hit of the game.
Will
bring up Brandon Jordan. He's sixth in the National League in hits. It's Brandon Jordan who flew out in the first. Strike to Jordan.
Woo! Oh.
1-1.
Come on, Hook.
Doing one.
Two balls and one strike. Corner, Jordan looking for a pitch to drive here. Philly's trying to get a rally started. Popped up. Over to Joe Jose Harrison. One out. We'll bring up Mikel Franco, who walked his first time up.
Mikel Franco.
Ball and no strikes.
He's gonna go. Sweet.
No. 2-0.
Let's win, Pirates. Come on.
Ball pretty well hit the deep right field. That ball is caught. And there is two outs. Bring up Adrian Beltre. He blew out his first time up. This is foul. No balls and one strike. That is line and caught by the right fielder. That'll retire the Phillies here in the third. We go to the bottom of the third, 2-0 Pittsburgh. Here's Andrew McCutchen. He flew out his first time up. Strike to McCutchen.
MVP.
Hit foul. 0-2.
Yep, that ball went out.
Smith, a little bit outside, two balls and two strikes. Bounces up there, full count. Josh Harrison waits on deck. Thought that could have been strike three. McCutchen is on for the leadoff walk. Here's Josh Harrison. McCutchen goes at his foul. McCutchen will go again and another foul. McCutchen's always going to try to steal a base.
Here we go.
Hit on the ground. That's going to be a tough one. He fires the first over footy out. McCutchen moves up to second. Didn't run on the pick that time. He'll bring up Jordy Mercer. He's 0 for 1. Ball and no strikes. On the inside corner, 1-1.
Ball, that's out.
Two and one. Chance at that one, but he fouled it. It's 2-2.
You can do it.
A little check swing bunt past Lee. Won't get him. A check swing infield single for Jordy Mercer. Oh, man. That took a crazy hop over Lee. Over his head, Lee filled it, but could not go in first in time for the out.
Come on, Pirate, you can do it.
That ball is flying in the right field. It's deep. Walker, it is gone. A three-run home run by Neil Walker. And Pittsburgh leads it 5-0. It looked like a routine fly ball, but it kept on traveling and traveling. That's the 10th home run by Walker. The Pirates lead the league in home runs is Corey Hart. The Phillies have a 5-run deficit here in the bottom of the third. No balls and two strikes. Go. Yes, he did. Hart not happy about that. Two outs there and a third. Philly still had the highest team RA in the National League. Here's Francisco Cervelli. No balls and one strike. One and one. 2-1. Fouled off the glove, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Little bouncer. Lee picks it up, fires over the first for the out. That'll retire the Pirates, but Neil Walker. It's a 3-run home run to give the Pirates a 5-0 lead. Fourth inning, simulcast on the Phillies Radio Network. Salvador Perez leads it off for the Phillies. Here in the fourth inning, Pirates with a 5-0 lead. Lock in and a windup. And the pitch to Salvador Perez is up high for a ball. 1 ball and no strikes. Locke has thrown 50 pitches in this game already. We are in the fourth. Here's the 1-0. Low, 2 balls and no strikes. A 2-0 on the way. Once again, low is 3-0 now. Darren Ruff waiting on deck. Philly's got to get something going here in the top of the fourth.
Let's go, Pirate, come on.
Lock ready. Here's the 3-0 coming. That's in for a strike, a little bit high, but he called that a strike. 3 balls and 1 strike to Perez. One coming. Swing and a foul. Now the count is full. Lock ready. The 3-2. Swing and a base hit in the center field. McCutchen plays on a couple of hops. Perez is at first. He leads off the fourth with a single. Bring up Darren Ruff. He walked his last time up. And Lock from the stretch. Here's the pitch to Ruff. In for a strike. No balls and 1 strike to Ruff. Lock again from the stretch in the 0-1. Low, 1-1. Lock steps off the rubber, now gets back on, gets his sign. A stretch now. 1-1 on the way. Inside, 2 balls and 1 strike. Stretch by Lock. 2-1 pitch. Swing, foul, just fouled out of first base side. Stretch by Lock. And the pitch. Swing and a base hit to right field. Darren Ruff gets a hit. The Phillies have their first 2 men on base here in the fourth. Nobody out. And they'll bring up Dominic Brown. Phillies have no bullpen activity, so Lee will probably bat for himself here. Brown is 0-for-1. He popped out in the second inning. Locked from the stretch. Here's the pitch to Brown. In for a strike. He checked his swing, but that was called a strike. 0-1. A stretch by Lock and the pitch. Strike 2. Brown steps out of the batter's box. Lock back on the mound. Getting a sign for Cervelli. A stretch. And the 0-2 pitch. Swing, a fly ball in the left field. It'll be caught. Nobody will advance. Caught by the left fielder. Nobody will advance. So it's one out. And we will see what Cliff Lee will do here. He had a hit. So will he bat for himself, or will he try to swing the bat, or will he try to move the runners along? Now the Phillies, they'll bring Xavier Paul in there. I wasn't sure the Phillies had any bullpen activity, but Xavier Paul is the pinch hitter. They had Lee on deck, but Ryan Sandberg pulled Lee out. A bro on Xavier Paul. Here's the pitch. It's in on the outside corner for a strike, 0-1. So Lee will exit the game, only pitching three innings, giving up five runs. Here's the 0-1. In for a strike, it's 0-2. Phillies, two runners on base. You don't want to waste an opportunity. They had a couple of runners on base in the last couple innings, but they have failed to capitalize. Locked from the stretch. The 0-2 pitch. Swing and a ground ball. It's off the bag. It's a fair ball. It was off the third base bag. They're ruling a fair ball. It'll be a hit for Xavier Paul. And the Phillies have the bases loaded here in the fourth. It was off the third base bag and deflected near the Pirate dugout. So it is a base hit. And they'll bring up Ben Revere, who was 0-2. Struck out and lined out. Phillies with a golden opportunity here in the fourth. Locked from the stretch. Here's the pitch to Rivera. This low for a ball. One ball and no strikes. 67 pitches thrown by Locke. The stretch. The 1-0 pitch. Swag at a foul. He chased that one. That ball was a little bit outside. Rivera chased it. It was foul. One ball and one strike. Here's the 1-1. Nice pitch. Nice breaking ball. One ball and two strikes. This will be the 70th pitch for Locke. He's ready. A 1-2 pitch. Outside and low. Two balls and two strikes. Chase Sutley on the on-deck circle. Stretch. A 2-2 pitch. Inside. Three balls and two strikes. No place to put Rivera. A stretch by Locke. And a 3-2 pitch. Swing and a ground ball. It's going to be a double play on the second for one. Back to first. Not in time. He stepped off the bag. A run scores. So it was a 5-1 ball game. A run batted in as Perez comes in to score. Phillies still stay alive in the inning. They'll bring up Chase Utley. Locke was pulled off the bag as he caught the ball from second. Utley is 2-for-2. He is singled twice. Here's a stretch by Locke. The pitch. In for a strike. No balls and one strike. Stretch by Locke. 0-1 pitch. A pitch out. They'll go on the second. Beats the throw. Nice steal by Ben Revere as he is in scoring position now with two outs. Rivera got a good jump. The throw was on the money, but Rivera beat the throw. Locke has thrown 74 pitches. It'll be his 75th. Here's the 1-1. Inside, two balls and one strike with Jordan waiting on deck. Here's the 2-1. Swing and a foul is now 2-2. Lock ready. 2-2 pitch. High, three balls and two strikes. See if the Phillies can get the bases loaded again and bring up Brandon Jordan. Runners will be off here. A stretch by Lock. The 3-2 pitch. Swing and a foul. Down the third base side. Count still full. Ninth pitch coming up. Lock ready. The 3-2 pitch. Outside ball four. The bases are reloaded for Brandon Jordan. Jordan is 0-2, flew out and popped out. Jordan in a big spot here with two outs. 80 pitches in this game for Lock. We're in the fourth. 5-1 Pittsburgh. Lock ready. Here's the pitch to Jordan. Is in for a strike. No balls and one strike. Stretch by Lock. The 0-1 pitch. Swag at a foul was low, but he got a piece of it. No balls and two strikes. Lock ready. The 0-2 pitch. Oh, they called it a strike three. I thought it was low at his side. Lock got lucky with that one. Jordan's called out on strikes. He is now 0-3. Phillies leave him loaded. We go to the bottom of the 4-5-1 Pittsburgh.
Your attention, please.
And Aaron Harang will come in as a new Phillies pitcher. It is 11th game, 12th game, 3-5, a 6.59 ERA. He's working out of the bullpen for right now. Jeff Lock
leading off the fourth inning.
Will lead off the fourth inning. Here's the pitch to Lock. It is a little bit outside for a ball. One ball and no strikes. Phillies with a golden opportunity with the bases loaded twice and only was able to get one run. Here's the pitch. High and inside. Two balls and no strikes. Here's a 2-0. Ooh. High, 3-0. You don't want to walk the pitcher in this situation. Phillies do have a high team ERA, among the highest in the National League. The 3-0 pitch right down the middle for a strike is three balls and one strike. Ring ready. And a 3-1 pitch. In for a strike is three balls and two strike. That one was on the inside corner.
Come on, Pirates.
Rang ready. A 3-2. Swing and a foul. Full count. Rang ready again. 3-2 pitch. Swing and another foul. Good at bat by Lock, making Harang throw a little bit. Here's the 3-2. Another foul. Harang ready. The 3-2 pitch. Sway and another foul. He's fouling the pitches off. Still a full count. Here's the 3-2. He walked him. Inside, he walked him. And they'll bring up Sterling Marte. He tripled and singled. All Swing ready. And the pitch. Swing and a foul. No balls and one strike. The 0-1. Got that over again. It's nothing in two. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Outside, one ball and two strikes. No 1-2 pitch. Set up outside again, and it's 2-2. Phillies right now, they have exhausted their bullpen a lot in this early part of the season. Stretch by Harang. A 2-2 pitch. Double play. So the Phillies get the double play that they needed. It's two down here in the bottom of the fourth. Bring up Jose Tabata. The pitch to Tabata. Low. One ball and no strikes. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Up high, two balls and no strikes. Two on the way. Swag and a base hit to left field. Laid on a couple of hops by Brown, and Andrew McCutchen will bat here in the bottom of the fourth. McCutchen's 0-for-1. He walked and scored the run. Harang waiting. And a pitch to McCutchen. Inside, one ball and no strikes. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Swing and a ground ball over to Franco. Fires over the second for the out. That'll end the bottom of the fourth. Pirates leave one. We go to the fifth. Matt Baskerzin joins you. 5-1 Pittsburgh.
Now here's the first pitch. And a check swing here, but he clearly went around on a pitch that would have been a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. Now the pitch. In there, and it's 0-2 now. Now here it comes. Low and away with that one. It's 1-2.
Well, I think that fastball is just for show there. He's not trying to throw this for a strike.
And that's high for a ball. It's 2-2.
Yeah, that's a good spot to miss against a guy like this. He loves that pitch up in the zone. Most power hitters do, so that's not a bad idea to give him one above the letters.
Here's the 2-2 home. Now a swing and a sharp ground ball to third. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. Adrian Beltre will take another shot here. He's flied out and lined out in two trips. First pitch coming. Now a ball hit high in the air, deep down the line in left, hooking just a little. Marte is back to the track as he takes it for out number two.
Yeah, and this ball was hit pretty well, but it was always going to stay in the ballpark. And you see the left fielder just drift back and make the play on the warning track.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one.
I like how he's approaching things here. He's got a good, safe lead, so he's not setting guys up or wasting a lot of pitches. He's coming right after everybody.
That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
And you kind of get the sense that he's not really messing around out there too much. There hasn't been a whole lot of setting guys up here in this inning. He's just trying to get himself back into that dugout as fast as he can.
And this is lifted high in the air down the right field line. And Tabata will make the catch, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. They're down here 5-1. Josh Harrison will stand in to lead things off in the bottom of the fifth. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. First pitch on the way. Good fastball there to start the at-bat as Harang jumps ahead, nothing and one.
Boy, good pitch, good spot. That thing tailed right back over the outside corner.
Now here's the pitch.
Here we go.
Swing and he pops it up over toward foul territory. And no one can get there. He'll try it again. And now a pitch on the way. Inside, as that perhaps will back him off a bit. 1-2.
Could be that high fastball there was just a setup pitch. Now you've kind of established that high sight level. Could be a good time to break off a nasty curveball.
Now the pitch. And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone.
You know, and I think most hitters will tell you, if you get a bad call on strike one or strike two, you know, they can live with that. But if you're going to punch me out on strike three, it better be a strike. If not, I feel like you're taking the bat out of my hands.
Here's Jordy Mercer now. As the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0.
A lot of late movement on that fastball. That nearly came back to the outer edge.
Here's the 1-0. Oh, this ball's laced, and it's going to get down into the right center field gap. He'll take the turn and head for second. And he's in there safely. He's got a double.
And this is how you break out of the cold streak. This is his second hit of the ball game. This one goes for extra base. You can see that confidence is slowly starting to come back.
Neil Walker will dig in. Had a three-run homer his last time. First pitch to him. And he gets ahead here with the fastball. Strike one. As a look, now the pitch. Now a big swing, and this is a major league pop-up. Way up there toward the center of the diamond. And this is taken in by Beltre for the second out.
Now batting, first baseman, Corey Hart.
Corey Hart will stand in now. He singled and struck out in two trips. First offering on the way. Fastball runs a bit inside here. It's 1-0.
Well, this is a spot where it helps to have a two-seam fastball like that so you can work in on the right-handed hitters.
The 1-0 pitch. Now it's 2-0.
Well, they're taking the smart approach right here. With that base open, you don't need to put them on intentionally, but you also don't need to groove anything.
Five runs, eight hits, and no errors so far for the Pirates. 2-0 count, the pitch. Over the outside half, and it's 2-1. Now the 2-1 pitch. This ball will be chopped foul. Here's the 2-2 offering. And a full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now.
Now, he does have first base open, so he doesn't have to come in right here. He can try to make that perfect pitch, and you know what? If he misses, who cares?
full count offering on its way. Inside with the fastball, and he works the base on ball. Francisco Cervelli. See what he can do here with two on and two out here in inning number five. First pitch coming. And he gets ahead 0-1.
And that's what he needed here with two outs. He couldn't afford to fall behind another guy here in the inning, so that's a good job to jump in that driver's seat with strike one.
Comes set. Now the pitch. Hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd foul. From the belt, the pitch. On the ground down the first base line, but this will wind up foul, still 0-2. He waits, now the pitch. And strike three called as he says, you gotta be kidding me, with the side retired. Pirates strand a couple. They're up 5-1. Darren Ruff will stand in to lead things off here in the Philadelphia sixth.
Darren Ruff.
Nice cold water here.
First pitch coming.
Wait.
High and tight here to begin the inning. It's ball one. Not too many strikeouts on the ledger for him so far, but it hasn't really mattered.
Yeah, I think ideally you'd like to see him miss a few more bats, but as long as you're keeping guys off balance and you're letting your defense help you, you don't need to strike a ton of guys out to be successful.
One one on the way. Down low, two balls and a strike.
Let's go.
2-1. Right on the corner, 2-2. Now the 2-2 pitch. And now this ball's lifted in the air down the right field line, but this will get back into the seats, so the count holds at 2-2. Ready with another 2-2. Now he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one.
Yeah, a good pitch there as he gets the pop-out on the fastball as we take a look at his pitch breakdown so far.
Dominic Brown will dig in again. He popped up in his first plate appearance and flew out last time around. Here's the first pitch to him. They'll try and entice him with a high fastball, but he wouldn't commit. It's ball one. EK, the starter, creeping up on 100 pitches now, but that number alone doesn't appear to be affecting him too much at all.
Yeah, he still looks sharp. Still, with the way that teams handle pitchers nowadays, I don't think he'll wind up going much further.
And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. It's a ball and a strike. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1.
And that's not a bad spot. Just go ahead and stay out there. Don't come down the middle because we know he can hurt you.
We're in the sixth inning now of a 5-1 ball game. Now the 2-1. Ball three.
And a good job here of making him throw a lot of pitches. I mean, he probably doesn't have a whole lot left in the tank, so the more you make him work, the better your chances of getting a mistake.
Now a swing by Brown as this ball is drilled out to deep right field. Oh, but it'll stay in the park as it hits high off the top of the scoreboard. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
Well, neither offense has really made a huge impact so far, but finally maybe a little sign of life. He drives this ball for two bases, and even though they've had trouble scoring runs, they're not out of this thing by a long shot. A couple more of these could get them right back into it.
Freddie Galvis is going to get off the bench here as he'll hit for the pitcher Harang. Now about a 58-foot breaking pitch that he wisely lays off here. Well, we'll give you a look there at the graphic. He picks up his sixth double so far on the year. Now it looks like a right-hander's up and throwing in the Pittsburgh bullpen. Here comes the 1-0. Now a fastball for a called strike. It's 1-1. One pitch on the way. Circle change here, but it's taken for ball two.
It doesn't take a trained eye to tell you. He's starting to wear down a bit out there on the mound.
Here's the 2-1 pitch. Here's a ball hit pretty well and carrying to deep right. Tabata back in plenty of time to put this away, however, and there are two gone. And he's up to third safely now with two gone in the inning.
Yeah, this ball's hit high enough that he can go back and tag at second base. So that's a good job of moving up the extra 90 feet now with two outs.
Ben Revere will try again, 0-for-3 thus far. Now the first pitch, ball one. I know we have a tendency in the media to get hung up on pitch counts, but this is a legitimate workload he's sweated through so far.
Yeah, anytime you get up around that 110 mark, you put in a full shift, and he's fast approaching it here.
The 1-0.
Just like that, lead off guy's aboard.
Here's Starling Marte as he'll swing and hit this one hard but foul off to the left and out of play. He's ready. Now the pitch. Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2.
And that's about where he'll sit with that fastball, 93, 94. And that's plenty hard enough to blow it by guys when you need to.
And he wastes a fastball high there, 1-2. Nobody out, runner on first. The right-hander deals on 1-2. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. There's one on to first, and they get them both.
Well, I think he had a bit of a lapse in concentration to that last guy. But no such problems here. This is a perfect pitch with a runner on first base as he gets him to bounce right into the double play.
Here's Jose Tabata now, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike.
Oh, and you wonder if maybe he decided beforehand just to take a pitch up there first. Too bad for him, because that thing was right down Broadway.
Now here it comes. And this ball's heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now. Now the pitch. Slider, but that's low as it's dug out by the catcher there.
And now, as a hitter, 1-2, you've got to be thinking right center field. They'll take a little swing out and try to drive something the other way.
Here's the 1-2. And this is going to be fouled into the diamond level seats. Bases are empty here with two men out. Here he comes again, 1-2. Now a swing and a hard hit ball to short. And he'll make that play look easy as the throw is in time to end the inning. Nothing doing here for Pittsburgh. They lead this one, though, 5-1.
Chase Utley leads off the seventh inning, and he takes a ball.
One ball, no strike.
Lincoln in the game for the Pirates. One ball and one strike. Phillies trying to make a comeback here. Down 5-1. It is one ball and two strikes now. Phillies have had their opportunities, but have not been able to cash in. Utley, little half swing and bounce, and Utley is thrown out. One down here in the seventh. They'll bring up Brandon Jordan, who's 0 for 3. Jordan hits this one in the air. And Sterling Marte will put it away. Two quick outs. There's Mikel Franco, who's 0 for 2.
Shortstop, Mikel Franco.
Inside, one ball and no strikes.
Nope,
2-0. Got that over, two balls and one strike. Little bouncer foul. Two and two.
Three balls.
Full count, Adrian Beltre waits on deck. Ground ball to short. This will end the inning. Oh, the ball is overthrown. It'll go out of play in the stands. And Franco will end up at second base. And they'll bring up Adrian Beltre. Just overthrew that one. I don't know what happened there. But they'll bring up Adrian Beltre. They're going to score that in E6. One ball and no strikes to Beltre. He fouls it. Phillies put up 6 runs and against the Reds in their final game of the series, but they've had their opportunities in this one. Two balls and one strike. Beltre hits this to short. Fires over the first, and he bobbled the ball. That's the second error. Oh, man, that is 2 errors on the same inning. Hart, that ball just bounced up on the ground, and another error on Joey Mercer. So 2 errors on Joey Mercer. Here in this inning, another E6, and here is Salvador Perez, so a chance for the Phillies to make some noise here. One strike. Well, at some point, you got to cash in on the opportunities. Even when it's 2 out, you still have to cash in. Bounces up there, one ball and one strike.
Don't let him
2-1. Bear Ruff waits on deck. Perez hits this one in the right field. It's pretty well hit. It is caught. That ball was hit pretty well, but Jose Tabata makes the catch, running into the fence. We go to the bottom of the seventh. It's 5-1 Pittsburgh, stretch time.
Your attention, please.
Genmar Gomez is a new pitcher for the Phillies. This is his 18th game with 11 strikeouts, 2 walks, a 2-0 record of 3.94 ERA. Is Ken Giles in the bullpen for the Phillies. Here's Andrew McCutchen. Wow, the Phillies have had their opportunities and McCutchen fouls it. A ball is a 1-strike to McCutchen. One. Two balls and 1 strike. Hit foul. Another foul. Inside for a count. Josh Harrison waits on deck. McCutchen, that is foul. McCutchen, a leadoff base runner here in the bottom of the seventh, is Josh Harrison. Harrison's 0-2. On the ball with no strikes. The Phillies, they're pitching. They have used their bullpen a lot this season. And you can see the fatigue within the bullpen. Ground ball at third base. Might be a double play on the second for one on the first. Double play. Nice double play turn by Adrian Beltre. 2 outs already in the bottom of the seventh. Nice glove work by Beltre. The Utley to Ruff. They've been used to saying Utley to Howard. Here's Jordy Mercer. Well, Mercer has had 2 errors in the same inning on back-to-back fielding plays. But he's had a great day at the plate. 1 ball and no strikes. One and one. Mercer base hit in the right field. Pirates keep the inning alive. There's a nice hit by Mercer. A ball down and in. He just hits it in the right field. Neil Walker in the third inning. He is responsible for this Pirates 5-1 lead. He hit a 3-run home run back in the third inning. Into the Susquehanna River. Popped up for Perez. They'll put it away, and that'll retire the Pirates here in the seventh. We go to the top of the eighth. Phillies down 5-1. There's Dan Ruff. He is 1-for-2. He leads off the eighth.
First baseman, Darren Ruff.
Phillies need to get some base runners, and they need to cash those runs in. Ball gets away. It's one ball and no strikes. It's a foul. Two balls and one strike. Two and two. Check him out. Down. They'll bring up Dominic Brown. He's 1-for-3, doubled into 6. Strike to Brown. One and one to count. Side, two balls and one strike. One account, Genmar Gomez waits on deck. Hit foul, 3-2. Off Dominic Brown. So it'll bring up Ryan Howard. He will pinch hit, but Genmar Gomez. Die, one ball and no strikes. One and one.
One ball, one strike.
Lincoln has thrown 33 pitches. Howard, this is a double play ball. Phillies are retired here in the eighth. We go to the bottom of the eighth, 5-1 Pittsburgh.
Your attention, please.
Ken Giles into the game. You see his numbers. He's 1-2 on the season. Game number 36, a 4.50 ERA. 25 strikeouts and 11 walks. And here's Corey Hart.
Leading up for the Pirates, first baseman, Corey Hart
fouls it. No balls and one strike. Oh, and two. Next broadcast will be at the final game of the Pirate Series. It'll be on WBRN UPN 57. That is Sunday. There's a strikeout for Giles, one down there in the eighth. Well, if you're wondering where are the other Phillies games broadcast, the other Phillies games are broadcast on the Prism YouTube channel. Go to youtube.com, type in the username prism.prismtv. There you will see games, commentary, and other sorts of stuff only on Prism TV. So check out that YouTube channel out. That's it, the Phillies games non-live gameplay commentary is on Prism TV. No balls and two strikes. One out here in the eighth. One and two. Two balls and two strikes. Foul tip struck him out. Two outs, and I'll bring a pinch hitter, Pedro Alvarez. Alvarez fouls him. Foul by Alvarez. No balls and two strikes.
Come on, Pedro, let's go.
Pass rough and in the right field. The Pirates turn the lineup over and they'll bring up Sterling Marte, triple single. Strikes. Pirates with 10 hits, the Phillies with 7. But the Phillies have had lots of opportunities to cash in on runs, and they have failed to move runners. That is foul. One ball and one strike. Hammer in the deep left field. Back goes Brown, and it is gone. 2-run home run for Sterling Marte. And the Pirates now lead it 7-1. Jake Diekman will come in now as the Phillies pitcher. 31 innings, 8 walks, 28 strikeouts. He's 1-0 in 35 games. He has a 1.16 ERA. As Marte's 5th home run of the season. And Tabata takes outside, 1 ball and no strikes. Tabata is 1-for-4. All in one strike.
Ball, that pitch is out.
2-1.
Come on,
here we go.
2-2. Struck him out, that'll retire the Pirates, but Sterling Marte with a 2-run home run in the bottom of the 8th. We go to the 9th, Pirates well out in front.
Your attention, please.
Tony Watson will come in. 32nd game, 31 innings, a 1-1 record, a 2.90 ERA, 10 walks and 26 strikeouts. Here's Ben Revere.
Center fielder, number 2, Ben Revere.
there, just trying to get on base here. Phillies have left runners on. But at this point, the game is pretty much academic here. One ball and one strike. There, fouls it. Another foul by Rivera. Two and two. Back through the middle, Rivera is on with a base hit.
Don't rush it.
The second baseman, number 26, Chase Utley.
And it'll bring up Chase Utley. One ball and no strikes to Utley. Utley 2 for 3. He's singled twice. One. Utley fouls it. One ball and two strikes. Little tapper off of the mound. Utley beats it out. An infield single, so it puts two Phillies on. Nobody out for Brandon Jordan. He is 0 for 4. Looking to get on the board with a base hit. Low, one ball and no strikes. That over, 1-1. One ball and two strikes to Jordan. Jordan has struggled at the plate here tonight. Two and two. Oh, the ball gets away. The runners are going to advance to second and third. Rivera third, Utley to second. And the count is 3 balls and 2 strikes. They'll score that a wild pitch. And foul. That ball slammed in the left field. It's pretty well hit, but caught by Marte. A runner's going to score. Give Jordan an RBI. It is now a 7-2 ball game.
The batter, number 7,
Phillies have hit it hard, but not hard enough. They'll bring Jared Hughes in his 34th game. He is 4-3 with a 2.27 ERA, 4 walks, 19 strikeouts, 31 2/3 inning. He'll face Mikel Franco. Low for a ball, one ball and no strikes. Franco pops it foul. And it will be caught. Two outs here in a ninth inning. Nice catch by Corey Hart. Right in front of the stands. It's up to Adrian Beltre to keep the game alive. Balls and one strike. Beltre is 0-4. Ooh, he chased an outside pitch. Pirates fans anticipating the last strike here. Fly ball center field, McCutchen there, and the Pirates beat the Phillies by the score of 7-2. Pirates did it with the long ball here tonight. Neil Walker. And Jordy Mercer. Pirates win it by the score of 7-2. Phillies had a couple of opportunities to get stuff, to get runs home, but failed to do so. And the bases loaded in the fourth, Revere grounded out, did not get a run. But you could have think that the Phillies could have had more than the two runs they had in the game. Pirates win 7-2 for the Pirates. 7 runs, 11 hits, 2 errors. The Phillies 2 runs, 9 hits. Nowhere. Jeff Locke gets the win. He's 3-5. Cliff Lee with the loss. He is 4-5 on the season. Well, the player of the game is Starlin Marte. He had 3 hits, the home run, and knocked in 4 RBIs. I said Jordy Mercer hit the home run. It was Starlin Marte. My mistake on getting the names wrong, but this was the home run by Marte. And this was a no doubt about it. And the Pirates end up winning the game by the score of 7-2. We'll talk to you Sunday on UPN 57.